coming up tonight on News in Depth. 18 years old to purchase land from government under new housing policy. Public servants could get a bonus for the Christmas. And a man followed and robbed in the finance ministry compound. News in Depth with Ivor Wharton begins now.
Tonight's edition of News in Depth, I'm Ivor Wharton. Thanks for joining us. First up, a shift in government policy will now see 18-year-olds being eligible to purchase house lots.
18-year-olds with the financial means can now apply for and purchase real estate from government. Junior Communities Minister with responsibility for housing, Valerie Adams-Patterson, made the announcement today in Parliament, where she was speaking in support of the 2017 budget.
You see, Mr. Speaker, in 2016 budget presentation, I alluded to the fact that there are a number of things that 18-year-olds can do legally. Applying for a house lot is not one of them. So during the months of September to November, I embarked on a number of consultations to garner the view of the public. The public is overwhelming in their support of changing the minimum age requirement from 21 years to 18 years to be eligible to apply for a house lot.
This, the minister explained, will take effect from January 3, 2017. The minister also explained that the housing sector is poised to do better in 2017, as she told the House that the ministry only spent 19.9% of its expenditure and achieved 30.5% revenue in 2016.
And I'm bringing this to the fore, Mr. Speaker, because I know that the opposition have their information, so we have no secret. Mr. Speaker, this agency has been plagued with numerous challenges, and the challenges were in the area of human resources, alleged corruption, lack of capacity in some regards.
Starting next year, government will be looking to build a number of low-cost housing for low-income earners and government workers.
We will return with more news after this break.
Make your wishes come true this Christmas at Lucky Dollar. You can't go wrong.
Add beauty and style to your home for the holidays with Windows from Beeson Windows and Doors. Whether you're renovating or building that new home, nothing compares to the class and beauty of Beeson Windows. Engineered by professionals and built to last longer than the competition, Beeson Windows will match any style, shape, and budget. And if we don't have what you want, we can custom make it for you. So visit our showroom today at 1228 New Echoes Industrial Site or BPATS Building on Regent Street. Call 622-419 or 226-1292. Happy holidays.
Thanks for staying with us. There is a glimmer of hope, as the finance minister said it is possible that public servants can receive a bonus for the Christmas holidays.
Speaking on 94.1 Hot FM during an interview with DJ Stan Gavaya, Minister Durden announced that if government decides to pay public servants a Christmas bonus, it will not be in their December salary, but rather before Christmas. Earlier, the government said that it is still looking to see if it could afford a year-end bonus for public servants. In an interview post the 2017 budget, Minister Durden explained that there was a very slim chance that the bonus will be offered this year. He said over the past year, there has been more investment and recruitment in the security sector, and with an increased salary bill, it may now be difficult to offer a year-end bonus to all public servants at this time. Last year, the government paid a 50,000 Christmas bonus to all public servants. Before that, only members of the joint services were paid 1 month's salary as a bonus.
Hey, what you doing? The time passing, next thing you know, it's a Christmas event and there's hustle and bustle and fretting. Every year can't be the same thing.
Don't get caught in the last minute rush. Shop the courts now. Get the best deals and the best prices on the world's best brands. Get a chance to win a staycation for two at the Arawai H2O Resort. Shop with Ready Finance and there's no down payment until January 2017.
Let's go, 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 let's go. I sell swaggerific. Spaniard me like staggerific. I Spaniard. When you stag, give me a hand on the world place. Turn up, turn up, turn up, turn up, turn up, turn up, stag up. Turn up, turn up, turn up, turn up, stag up. Turn up, turn up, turn up, turn up. Stag in me hands now. Hand up, hand up, hand up, hand up, stag up. Hand up, hand up, hand up, hand up, hand up, hand up. Stag up, stag up. Tell them no. I don't business if you're not on time. You must always have stag in the line. Well, everybody have a stag in the hand. Where's mine? Stagerman's beer.
Add beauty and style to your home for the holidays with windows from Beeson Windows and Doors. Whether you're renovating or building that new home, nothing compares to the class and beauty of Beeson Windows. Engineered by professionals and built to last longer than the competition, Beeson Windows will match any style, shape, and budget. And if we don't have what you want, we can custom make it for you. So visit our showroom today at 1228 New Echoes Industrial Site or BPATS Building on Regent Street. Call 622-419 or 226-1292. Happy holidays!
A daring robbery in the compound of the Ministry of Finance saw two gunmen escaping with $3 million.
A supervisor's national gunshot wung after he was shot and robbed in the compound of the Ministry of Finance headquarters on Main Street this afternoon. This news house understands that the man was traced by two bandits in a car. The victim tried evading the men by seeking shelter in the Ministry of Finance building. But this did not deter the bandits, who shot the man and took his bag that contained $3 million in cash and hurriedly left the scene in a waiting car. The building has armed security guards on duty, but they were caught totally off guard and had to seek cover after gunshots rang out. The police in a release to the press said investigations have revealed that the victim, John Bryan, was walking on Orqua Street, North Cumminsburg, heading in a westerly direction when a white Primo motor car pulled up alongside him and two suspects, one armed with a handgun, exited and approached him. As a result, he became afraid and ran to the Ministry of Finance gate and threw a haversack, which was alleged to contain $3 million in cash, into the said compound. The 29-year-old man was shot in his thigh. The victim was rushed to the Georgetown Public Hospital in an ambulance where he is undergoing surgery. Investigators have retrieved a spent shell from the scene. No arrests have so far been made.
That's a wrap for this edition of News in Depth. Do join us again same time tomorrow for another edition.